I'm Dan Wilson. I'm a PhD student in the Fitzpatrick Lab at the Max Planck Florida Institute for Neuroscience. Interacting with the world through vision is really a defining feature of human existence. It's important that we study the visual system. Research in the lab is focused on understanding the structure and function and the development of the visual system. One thing that really excites me about coming into lab every day is that I have the opportunity to learn something new. To me, this is really the reason to do research, is that you have this really unique opportunity to learn something new every day. I was born in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. In high school, I had a teacher that had previously worked as a research scientist, and I think he saw that I was curious about understanding how things work beyond what's described in the textbook. So he put me in contact with his old boss, and I eventually went to go work in the lab doing basic science research during the summer after high school. Research can be challenging because your experiments don't necessarily give you the results you predict. When this happens, you have to adjust your thinking to accommodate your new data. It's been hard for us to develop a cohesive model to help us think about our results. But I think now we're at that place and we have some nice results. What we're trying to do is to take advantage of new imaging technology so that we can image brain cells in three dimensions at high rates. And this will allow us to understand what individual neurons in the brain do. You can see the individual synaptic inputs light up when we show a stimulus. Like there, and there.
That's the whole branch. Oh, that's there you go. So there's the two individual inputs.
Yeah, there
are
the individual inputs.
What is that? Is this another spine protrusion, or is that?
That's a filopodia.
Really?
Yeah.
Anyway, what's the difference between filopodia and spine?
I think one difficult thing about going into research is finding the right place to be. Different labs work on different things, and they operate in different ways. So just because you want to do research doesn't mean you'll find a good fit in every lab. It's important to tailor the lab you want to work in with your personality and your interests. There's a great deal that's unknown about how individual neurons process information in the brain. And to me, this is really fundamental to understanding how the brain works. And this is the reason I do the work that I do. For students that want to do research, I think it's really important that they begin doing lab work as soon as possible so that they can be familiar and comfortable with being in a lab setting, designing experiments, and thinking about data.